Let's start.
I will try to explain something scientific. And I ask Ivo to translate it, I don't know.
Expert in scientific English.
He is not expert in scientific English.
I will help you.
I will explain you somehow. Едно от така най-забележителните неща на геологична гледна точка на белградските скали е, че това са едни от най-старите скали на планетата.
Okay, so one of the most notable things about the Belovežan rocks is that they're one of the most ancient rocks on the planet.
One of the most ancient.
Вулканичен скали, вулканичен произход, магма.
Yeah, they're volcanic rocks from magma.
Които са се формирали при формирането на планетата на Земята още.
Yeah, which formed back when the planet was still forming.
И са били на морското дъно, тъй като по това време всичко е било море.
They were on the bottom of the ocean because at that time everything was water.
И са формирани от вулканични изригвания, които по това време формирането на планетата са били на всяка земя.
So they formed from volcanic eruptions which at that time happened there.
И след това постепенно са около тях се формирала тиня, пясък и те са били обвити на морското дъно много милиони години в пясък и тиня.
And after that some mud and sand started amassing on top of the rocks and they were still underneath the water, you know, for a lot of time.
И когато се са доказали на планините, този пясък постепенно е почнал да се рони, да ерозира, става ерозия.
And when they came out of the water, when they emerged, the sand, the mud, everything started to erode. That's why they left the rocks like that.
Докато накрая остават само вулканичните форми, които са се формирали при изтиването на магма.
Until at the end, the only thing remaining were the original forms of the magma from the volcanoes that were the form
много забележително, че тези форми до такава степен приличат на същества от нашия свят, които всеки може да разпознае.
As you can see, they look very much like things you see in your everyday life, like people and animals and stuff, and that's why they have the names.
И сега ще ви кажа няколко, тъй като автобус още го няма. Няколко думи от историята на региона. Вече говорихме за че тук са се разхождали първите човешки същества. Затова Елена, може би ще ви разкаже малко повече в автобуса.
So now he'll just tell you something about the history of the area. And as we already said, one of the first humans, well, the first human in Europe. One of the first humans in Europe were like walking among these.
Забележителното на природата е гората тук. Тъй като това е хилядолетна гора.
What's really interesting about this area is the forest, because it's thousands of years old. It hasn't been touched.
Както вече обясних на някои от вас, борчетата, черния бор, който може да се види по върховете на скалите, някои от тези борчета са да по 200-300 години, дори и повече.
Има и снимки или какво беше?
Да, значи на Калето има една много интересна история с едното борче, което е върху скалите, тъй като то се вижда на литография от края на 17 век. Края на 18 век, простете, от края на 18 век по времето на Софрон и Врачански. След това го има на снимка от Руско-турската война, от Балканската война и в момента се изглежда по същия начин.
Не е пораснало.
These trees are really, really, really older than they look. The small pine trees which are on top of the rocks. Some of them are hundreds of years old. And what was 17th?
Край на 18.
Okay, and there's a funny story with there's one particular rock with a small pine tree on it. And if you go up the fortress up there, there's a castle, something like that. That's been used with from many cultures, whatever. You can see an old lithography where you can see the rock and the little pine. And there's another
photograph.
Okay, so yeah, from like the 17th century. And then 18th century.
18th. The end of 18th century.
Yeah, and after. then you have a photograph from the
end of 19th century.
Yeah, from the end of the 19th century with the same rock and the same tree. And if you look at it now, it looks exactly the same. And it's a really small tree. You can
be a daughter of the other.
No, it's the same. Тъй като бил процесите вътре, понеже върху скала интензивността е много слаба. И поради това тази причина тези дървета живеят много по-дълго. Те не се развиват, не стават големи, стават са много сухи. Обаче всъщност живота им се удължава.
So the reason for this is that the trees are actually growing on rocks. This is why the biochemical processes inside of them are really, really slow. And that's why they don't become very big, but they live a very long life.
По отношение на културата, ние за съжаление сега нямаме възможност да посетим Калето крепостта. Но интересното, когато дойдете следващия път до Калето, е, че основите на Калето са от праисторията още. След това имат първите, най-долната част, първите камъни отдолу за тракийска крепост. Most closer to my family. Well, some other time you went to visit the fortress. There is it's a very interesting in a cultural historical point of view because the lowest stones are from the ancient time.
Prehistoric time.
Before Romans.
Prehistoric.
Century before Christ. The Thracian fortress. There was a Thracian tribe called Tribali, and they built the first fortress. And the interesting thing that is that this fortress is on the rocks. And part of the fortress is the rock itself. The other part is artificial. Win the war and build their own Celtic state here in this region. For 300 years there was a Celtic state. And after that came the Romans and conquered the Celts and the Thracians and the local people so on. And it was a part of the Roman Empire, of course, and after that of Byzantium. And after that came the old Bulgarian tribes and make their own pagan Bulgarian state. They become Christian in the 9th century. And we have two empires, the first and the second Bulgarian empire in the Middle Ages, of course. Sometimes it was the most powerful empire in the
area,
Southeast Europe. Then come the Ottomans, the Ottoman Empire. The conqueror, Bayezid, the flashlight and the thunder.
Yeah, that's what they call it. Ottoman Empire.
And in these times, the Bulgarian Empire split into two different states because of the emperor, John Alexander, who has two sons. The first son was from his
John, and then Ioan.
If you look at the Encyclopedia Britannica, it's written like that.
Yeah. Ivan Alexander.
His first son was from his Bulgarian wife. The first wife, the queen was a noble family, Bulgarian noble aristocrats. But he fell in love in a Jewish girl, Sarah, because many from the Spanish Jews came to Bulgaria because here there was no chasing of Jews, no chasing of the heresy. There are so many groups. The official church was heretic. It was the Isikazamica as a part of the Bogomili. That they form in the Western Europe Augigoi, Katars, and Augigoi.
And there's a Bijouan, etc.
Bugrids came from Bulgaria. And the emperor fell in love with this Jewish girl, and he wanted to get divorced. It's queen, but the patriarch, it's the head of the Bulgarian church, didn't want to make this divorce because there is no reason to make it. And he said that the patriarch is a Byzantine spy, and he executed him. Put his first wife in a
monastery.
Married to Sarah, the second son was from Sarah. Ivan. Drugi Ivan Stratimir Barbara.
John Stratimir.
Two sons from two women. He split the emperor into two, and he kept the firstborn prince. The capital of Vidin, it was nearby on the Donau, which is maybe 20 kilometers. And he was a great it was in the end of the 14th century. The other one is in Ternovo. And first fall from the Ottomans, the Ternovo, the first capital, and the only state, the Bulgarian state, is the first prince here, Ivan Stratimir. And because he wanted to make some kind of Christian coalition against the Ottomans, they become Catholic because of the contract with the Bulgarians, with the French, with the Burgundians, with the Austrians, with the Italians before. And all the Vidin state becomes Catholic. And after that, here came the fourth or the fifth saint to save Vidin, to save this state. And the most famous knight in this crusade was the famous Burgundian duke.
Jean Saint-Pierre.
Because of that that this knight was so, this duke was so fearless. He was very stupid. He tried to fight in a mud, in Nikopol, in the dune. Плато, отресавище.
Марш.
Yes.
Марикажа,
yes. And then the Turkish Sultan is Bayezid, the Thunder.
The Thunder.
Just killed all them in the marsh, all the knights. It all becomes red and blood. And captured Jean
Saint-Peur.
The Duke. And after that, the Vidin state fell under the Ottoman Empire. But the princess, the Bulgarian princess Maria, was very beautiful, and the Sultan, the Bayezid Thunder, fell in love with her, and he made his first woman and the mother of the next Sultan.
This is the most important female position,
and maybe one of the most important positions in the Ottoman Empire.
First wife,
yes, the mother of the Sultan's children, the first son,
successor,
firstborn son. And the boyars, the boyars, that's the Bulgarian aristocracy, some kind of barons. They flew from Vidin and they go to Tsiprusy then, because there was the most richest town in this period because of the gold mines. And there was the goldsmiths and so on, and it was a very rich population. And some of the nowadays also Tsiprusy families connected with the first boyars, like families, aristocratical families, like Soimirovich, Knyazevich. Knyazevich means prince, and they have some kind of connection with the old Bulgarian aristocracy. And nowadays, some of their descendants are also barons. They live in Austria. They come to Tsiprusy every year on the 6th of September. Then the Tsiprusy people make a contract with the Ottomans to be a town only that pays his taxes only to the first Sultan wife, who is the Bulgarian. That means that no one Turkish one can eat in the city. No one, the Turkish one, can pass the city on the coast. And there is absolutely autonomy of this place. The aristocracy made autonomy. They get its own heraldics. You saw it in Egypt. Yes. There was something like the Burgundian dukes and so on. I don't know, Herzog. It was very, they are Catholic from the, Franciscans, from the Saint Francis Brother. And they were too closely connected with Italy. They go to Italy to learn. Also one of the Italian universities at this time was high school, was called the Bulgarian school. But it was not very good to travel so long. They decided to make his own school in the town of Tsiprusy. They tried to form the first three faculties of the university. Mathematics, law, law, philosophy, and
medicine,
theology. And well, this, where under this historical hill was the monastery, which is the first Bulgarian
museum. Where's the museum?
It's called Seminario. And that's the connection. The historical connection was the name of the water from there. So maybe our building could be on the historical hill. And also our lectures were there. And the chief of the duke or baron, his title was baron, Peter Parcheli, tried in the end of the 17th century to make an anti-Ottoman coalition to free all the Bulgaria in order that he became Bulgarian chief or emperor or something like that. And he went to the Habsburg Emperor, the Austrian Emperor, make some contracts with intention to go to the Russian Emperor and all the same. And in all his letter he sighs like the ruler from Bulgaria. Well, it's nearly the end. After that there was three or four Austro-Ottoman war this period. During the first, this wars also become because of this Bulgarian baron, there was like a collision between the Russian and the Austrian. There was also some kind of willing to change the schism and the Orthodox and the Catholic Church become one because of this war together. But this doesn't happen yet. The first war freed Belgrade. And that was the first loss of the Ottoman.
Which year was that?
Well, it was the same war when was the Cypriots'
uprising.
Uprising.
Uh-huh.
1688. Uh-huh. The Cypriots' uprising was actually not uprising. It was a part of the war. And it was the Cypriots' rebellions was not rebellions. There was an army with Austrian uniforms. And that's why the Turks become so aggressive and so angry in this period. And they make decision to slaughter all the Christian population on the borders. Because they just against the empire when something happens, of course. But they cannot make this
Thank you.
Thank you.